So now that cap iron's prepared, what we now want to do is position it correctly onto the iron. Don't watch this video without seeing the previous one. If not, it'll just look like a bloke hitting a bit of metal with a screwdriver, which is basically what it is. All of my planes, all of my irons, all on the bench planes anyway, have some degree of a camber on them. I love cambers. I'm not into just nicking the corners. I like to camber the full iron. It's just easier to sharpen. So the finest of my smoothing planes, right up to my rough planes, they all have that camber. And it is perfectly compatible with cambers. It's just less so the bigger the camber gets. It's pointless, basically. We'll talk more about the cambers later on. But what I'll focus on first of all is the smoothing plane, which is where it's most important. It's where most people will find it beneficial. Now, the positioning of the cap iron to the cutting edge of the iron is absolutely dependent on the thickness of shaving you intend to take. If you set this up and you literally can't see the light off the edge, you've set it so fine up to that edge, and then you want to take an eighth inch shaving off, good luck, it ain't going to happen. The same goes if you want to take the most wispy thin shaving and you've set the cap iron eighth inch back. The cap's doing nothing. It won't do anything. So we've got to understand what we're wanting our planes to do in order to set this correctly. I have to do it in methods that guarantee efficiency, should we say. So if there's a veneer caliper or some sort of engineering gauge in here, it ain't got a place. I don't use them. I haven't got one in here. It's as simple as that. You don't need them to do it. And I think a lot of confusions or misunderstandings on the cap iron come from our obsession today to take the finest shaving possible. I've seen shavings at shows that can go upwards, they're that fine. And that takes the human element out of being able to set these things fast and accurately. Because that shaving must be a billionth of an inch thick, whatever that is. And we've got to then position this bloody thing a billionth of an inch off the edge of the cutting edge. And it's just not realistic in my head. So I'm looking at these fine shavings and I'm listening to these talks of tear out. And I'm thinking, well, my bloody shavings look more like cardboard. Why aren't I getting tear out? And the simple fact is, my cap iron was never set stupidly close to the edge. I mean, it's very close on my finer planes. I'm not saying it has to be set back, not at all. It's got to be very close to that edge. But my shavings were always of some substance. And therefore, the fact that, let's just say it was half a mil off the cutting edge, that's not a big gap, but it's certainly not close by some people's standards. But my shavings are probably approaching that, even on a smoothing cut, I don't bloody know. But that's why I wasn't encountering trouble. That's why the way I was shown doesn't tear, because it's shown for practical usage. So to position this on a real world shaving, I'm not into this fine stuff, I've made that clear. Let's put that screw back on, it's a bit bent over. You can just nip it up by hand and you can wiggle it close as you like. Don't get right to the edge, just get something like, you can get your screwdriver and just nip it up. And then to really get it where you want, just tap it. That's about there. You want it the same all the way along. On most planes, let's just say you've been sharpening this a few times and you've knocked the iron slightly out of square at the end. It's no biggie. You can just tap it and skew the cap iron on it a bit. Obviously, over time, you're going to have to straighten that up a bit. So that's all I do, and tap it up. And I get it as close as I can till I can just see a bead of light. I don't know what that bloody measurement is. I couldn't give you it. If it's less than an eighth, it's unmeasurable. That's my sort of motto on all of this. And that's it. That would be set up now to take any smoothing cut I would need. I don't know if you can see anything on there. It's not particularly close, I don't think. Well, look at it, but it works. So to me, that's the beauty of the cap iron. It really allows us to take practical size shavings, shavings that are getting the bloody job done, and still maintain absolutely no tear out. And you shouldn't be getting tear out if you've set these up right. The thinner shavings, in my opinion, the ones that go upwards, not down, they work perfectly in high angle planes. They work much better in, they respond better to a tight mouthed plane. So there's nothing wrong with them. They just don't, in my opinion, have the best place for a cap iron. They'll work perfectly well, but you've just got a job setting that up every time. Now, setting these up on heavier cambered planes, or heavy cambered irons, I mean, what we've got here, we've got something averagely cambered. That would be probably somewhere around the triplane region. So we'll just get rid of that. Now, I want to do a complete and utter separate video on cambers, because I think cambers aren't as simple as just putting a random round edge on your cutting edge. You've got to, there's a lot more to them. You're wanting to optimise them to the job in hand. The last thing you want is this great big camber on it, and all you're taking is this bloody half-inch shaving out the middle that's really thick. It defeats the object. You've got all this width and you should use it. So what I tend to find, what optimises them, so this camber here, I don't know what it is, you can probably see, if I put this cap up to it, you might be able to get a gauge of the depth. So it's about 1/16 in the middle to nothing either edge. So that's quite a fairly useful size, or should I say camber, it's a useful curve. So in order to set that up, all I'm going to do is nip it down and ensure, let me just tighten this up so it's not moving on us, and ensure that on the edges, the each of the edges, it's flush with the cap iron, and then it has set itself. That's all you need to do on a cambered iron, and it'll work, because this is now optimized for its max thickness shaving it can take. And that's the width of shaving. That's really what your plane should be doing. You don't want to be, like I say, taking this skinny little thing out the middle. It's a bit pointless. If I look over here, I'll just pull this one out. God knows what state this is in. I wish I never took it out when we see it, probably. This is a good hogging plane. You can see it's fairly good camber on there. And again, the cap is it's just thrown in. I'm not being precise on these thick things. I actually have planes with cap irons, without cap irons, because I do personally find I would rather get my iron out quicker and have it always a keen edge over just trying to get a few more shavings out of a dull iron because of the fast taking it off. But you can see here, I've just set it up to the corners. And again, that's optimised for its own shaving, its heaviest shaving. Once you start getting to these thicker curbs and cambers, honestly, you're not gaining knack all benefit really to having them, because if you're tearing out at that level too deeply, you're either going too close to your lines with a coarse plane, or you just want to use a finer plane. It's simple as that. So ultimately, as a summary, the always just make sure you're setting that cap iron to the thickness of shaving you intend to take. And your irons, if they are cambered correctly, will already be telling you how to set that, because you just set it to the two corners every time. If it's a fine smoothing plane, do something like that and you'll be there. And ultimately, experiment. Have a little play. You're not going to hurt anything tapping it a bit closer. If you go too close, it'll just clog it up a bit. And just loosen it and tap it back a bit. And that's all I do, is I like it nipped up and just hit it about. You're not going to hurt it, you just tap it where you want. It's far easier than trying to set it up on something or try to see it, because as soon as you turn it, it bloody moves anyway. So that's three wretched videos now about cap irons. It's starting to get a little dull. You should, however, now have the basic understanding of what this thing is. I encourage you to experiment, to play a little bit. It's a very touchy-feely thing and not fixed. Different timbers, different tools. You get the picture. Different monkeys on the tools. Mastering this will eradicate tear out with a minimal of fuss.